human cheek cell as seen under a microscope. For this, you need to take a clean toothpick or a matchstick with the tip broken, scrap inside of your cheek without hurting it. Place it on a drop of water on a glass slide. Add a drop of iodine and place a cover slip over it. Alternatively, add 1-2 drops of methyl blue solution. Observe it under microscope. You may notice the several cells in a scrapped material. And yes, you are able to identify the cell membrane, cytoplasm, the nucleus, a cell wall is absent in animal cell. So yes, you are able to identify the cell wall is actually absent. So this one is the cell membrane. The outermost this covering is there, that is the cell membrane. If you consider the nucleus, so all these bodies, these bodies are the nucleus. Means here you are able to see here, all these are the nucleus. In the nucleus we have seen the nucleolus is there. Okay, and here in this means the cell membrane, you are able to see some jelly-like structure, that is nothing but the cytoplasm. And yes, a cell wall. Okay, if you consider the cell wall, so cell wall is absent in animal cell. So in this way we have seen the human cheek cell. Now plant, just observe the structure of plant cell. So yes, here in this small square also, here in a small rectangle also, one diagram is given of the plant cell. You are able to identify here specifically the cell wall, cell membrane. The big vacuole is present, chloroplast, nucleus, and the small mitochondria. If you go in detail, you are able to identify all these things in the plant cell. Okay, so this is the basic structure of the plant cell. Now afterward we are going to see its working one by one. Now observe the structure of animal cell. So yes, here you are able to see the cell membrane, cytoplasm, mitochondria, and nucleus. You are getting that here cell wall is absent, as a cell wall is absent in animal cell. If you consider the vacuoles, if you compare the vacuoles, so compared with the plant cell, in animal cell vacuoles are a small one. Lysosomes are there, they are also known as the suicide bag. Then Golgi vesicles are present, rough to if we consider the endoplasmic reticulum, so there is a rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So as you are able to see here, in rough endoplasmic reticulum there are some nodes present, okay, and in smooth endoplasmic reticulum there are no any kind of such nodes. So these nodes are nothing but the ribosomes. So these ribosomes are present over these reticulum, so they are known as the rough because they are not smooth one. Okay, these nodes make it rough. So this rough endoplasmic reticulum and this on the smooth endoplasmic reticulum there is no presence of the ribosome. Mitochondria is also known as the energy house, okay, or the energy house means what? So whatever energy required, so it is created by this mitochondria. You have seen here a nucleus. In nucleus there is a presence of a nucleolus, and this nucleolus actually contain the thread-like structure which is known as chromosome, and they carry the genes. In detail we are going to see further. Now in cytoplasm all these organelles are moving, okay. The ribosomes are also present in the cytoplasm. Plasma membrane is the outermost covering of the animal cell. Just once again see the structure of an animal cell in detail. So you are able to see here vacuoles, then mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes. So here that rough endoplasmic reticulum and the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, nuclear membrane. The nuclear is separated with the nuclear membrane, and in that nucleus there is a nucleolus. So in detail you are able to see here how the lysosomes, cell membrane, okay, cytoplasm. Now in detail we will see the part of cell. So the main part of the cell are cell membrane, or we can say it as a plasma membrane, cytoplasm and nucleus. The cell membrane gives a shape to the cell, protects the inner part of the cell and allow movement of material in and out of the cell. In plant cell, the cell membrane is covered by another thick covering called cell wall. The cytoplasm is a jelly-like substance between the cell membrane and nucleus. It contains other components like the mitochondria, Golgi bodies, rhizomes, ribosomes, as well as the vacuoles. One by one we will see exactly the function of all these organelles. So first we will see the nucleus. So yes, it is an important component of the living cell. It is generally spherical and located in the center of the cell. It can be seen and seen easily with the help of a microscope. When we have seen the slide of onion peel, so we are staining it with the safranin solution. Whenever we are staining it with the safranin solution, we are able to see the nucleus. So nucleus is separated from the cytoplasm by a membrane which is called as the nuclear membrane, and this membrane is also porous, which allows the movement of material between the cytoplasm and inside the nucleus. As a cell wall we have seen, or the cell membrane we have seen, they are porous for the movement of substances or materials. Both means the movement of the material should be from both sides, from inward and outward. If you see the if you see with the microscope of higher magnification, we can see a smaller spherical body in the nucleus. It is called as the nucleolus. In addition, nucleus contain thread-like structures called chromosomes. Chromosomes carry the genes and helps in inheritance or transfer of characters from parents to the offspring. The chromosomes can be seen only when the cell divide. Now just we will see what is mean by the gene. So gene is unit of inheritance in living organism. It control the transfer of hereditary characters from parents to offspring. So this means that your parents pass some of their characters on to you. If your father has a brown eye, you may also have the brown eyes. If your mother has curly hair, you might also end up with having curly hair. However, the different combination of the genes from a parent results in different characteristics. So, nucleus, in addition to its role in inheritance, actually it acts as the control center of the activities of the cell. The entire content of living cell is known as the protoplasm, and this protoplasm includes the cytoplasm and the nucleus. Protoplasm is also called as the living substance of the cell. So just see, if you go in detail of the nucleus, okay. So the nucleus is the prokaryotes, termed as the prokaryotes and eukaryotes. So what it means? So see, the nucleus of the bacterial cell is not well organized like the cells of the multicellular organisms. Because there is no nuclear membrane is present, and the cell having the nuclear material without the nuclear membrane is termed as prokaryotic cells. The organisms with these kind of cells are called as the prokaryotes. Means pro means what? The primitive, and karyon means the nucleus. For example, if you see the bacteria, blue-green algae, so they are the example of the prokaryotic cell. The cells like the onion cells and chick cells having well-organized nucleus with nuclear membrane are designed as eukaryotic cells. All organisms other than bacteria and blue-green algae are called eukaryotes. Eu means true and karyon means the nucleus. Now see, prokaryotic cells, they are not having the well-developed nucleus, while the eukaryotic cells are having the well-organized nucleus with the nuclear membrane. So this is the difference in the prokaryotes and the eukaryotes. Now we will see the structure of animal cell and the plant cell. Before that, just we will see the vacuoles. So vacuoles are the blank looking structures, okay, in the cytoplasm. So vacuoles are large in size in plant cell and small in size in animal cell. The function of the vacuole is like the storage. The vacuoles are the storage for the plants. Plant cell have the several colored bodies in the cytoplasm, which is called as the plasticide. The green colored plasticides are called as the chloroplast, and they contain the chlorophyll, which actually help in a photosynthesis, as a chlorophyll is absorbing the sun heat and which is useful in the process of photosynthesis. So in this way we have seen the parts of the cell. Now just we will observe and compare the structure of animal cell as well as the plant cell. So here you are able to see both animal cell as well as the plant cell. So you are able to observe here the presence of cell wall is there in a plant cell, and in animal cell there is absence of the cell wall. Then you are able to see here the vacuoles are big in size, and in animal cell the vacuoles are small in size. So according to its parts, just we will check its, just you are able to see here. Now the animal cell we will see. So the cell wall is absent, plasticides are absent, chromosomes are present, then absence of the large vacuole as well as the carbohydrates are stored as the glycogen, and lysosomes are present. In plant cell, if we consider, okay, this is the ultrastructure of the animal cell as well as the plant cell. So the plant cell, if we consider, the cell wall is present, plasticides are present, then chromosomes are absent, presence of large vacuoles, carbohydrates are stored as a starch, and lysosomes usually absent. So in this way we have seen the plant cell as well as the animal cell as a comparison. Now we will see this comparison with the chart. So just see here the parts, here the columns like the part, serial number, part, then plant cell and animal cell. With actually the organelles, we have to compare the plant cell as well as the animal cell. So first we will see about the cell membrane. So cell membrane is present in plant cell as well as the cell membrane is present in animal cell. If you consider the second, cell wall, so the cell wall is present in plant cell, but cell wall is absent in animal cell. We have seen why the cell wall is absent in the animal cell. because in a plant cell they are not able to move, they need to protect from the drastic conditions of the climate. So for that they are having the another layer of the cell wall. Nucleus, if we consider, so nucleus is present in plant cell as well as nucleus is present in animal cell. 4. Nuclear membrane. Nuclear membrane, if you consider, so in plant and animal, both in both cells the nuclear membrane is present. Cytoplasm is present in plant cell, and yes, cytoplasm is present in animal cell also. Plasticides. So plasticides, as we have seen, the different colored bodies are there which contain actually in plant cell the chloroplast. Correct. So these plasticides are present in plant cell, but plasticides are absent in animal cell. Vacuoles, if you consider, so vacuoles are in both, they are present, but in plant cell the vacuoles are very large in size, and in plant, in animal cell they are very smaller in size. So in this way we have compared both plant cell as well as the animal cell with respect to cell membrane, cell wall, nucleus, nuclear membrane, cytoplasm, plasticide and vacuole. So just so